Okay, folks, let's see what we can do with this one. Make this one come up a treat. Looks like it's raining again, folks. It has been. So let's just get back to the pierogi. So this is our, back to our badge flashing. Okay. I think it's going to be a dot matrix. We're going to make this an interesting piece. The nerds will inherit the copier world. Yes, they will, folks. Already done that. Okay, let's see what we have. We have here what I call a snooty magazine, the North Shore Times. Let's see how we go. Similar to the Mosman Times, except it's from the general, I think it's the whole of the North Shore, not just Mosman. So let's see how we go with this. And it's still a snooty. It's as northern suburbs of Sydney, up a bit further up from where I live. This is not sliding very well. I've got to lubricate the glass with some spray, some waterproofing spray that I've got, to make the magazine slide a bit easier. It's got silicon or silicone. Let's see how we go. Yeah, that's come up looking quite interesting. It looks a bit dark, but I like the overall, the shape of the face. So I'm going to enlarge it on the vertical and maybe a little bit on the horizontal and make that into something really nice. Looks a bit dark though. I think I darkened it. I think dot matrix was a little bit too drastic. I do wonder if maybe we're just going to lighten it and we're just going to... Okay, I'm just going to toss that in the recycle. Yeah, that's come up looking quite interesting. It looks a bit hot. Looks a bit too magenta-ish, but I like the shape of it overall. I do wonder if I can make it a little bit less. Yeah, I don't know if I like it. Looks a bit too fucking hot. I don't know why it's like that, folks. I've got a gut feeling. I don't know. I'm just going to work with it. Fuck, this user interface is a pain. Company that built this dumb fuck machine is an idiot. Stupid man in control of Konica Minolta, his name is Shai Amana. He can't build anything good. This is supposed to simulate a mobile phone functionality, but it doesn't really. It's just bullshit. It's just fucking smoke and mirrors advertising crap this Konica fucktard Minolta gets up to. You know, they're fucking idiots. They don't care about anything except their bloody money, and that shows in their product. And the whole thing is just shit. I've said it before so many times, I feel a bit weak in my breath saying any more about fucking this company that built this dumb machine. And that's come up looking quite cold, but that's how we would like it to be a bit cold, but I'd like a bit of extra colour in it. Maybe a bit of, oh, fuck, I don't know what to do with this one, folks. I fucked it up with the mastering. I do think we're going to go back to dot matrix again. Maybe if we go here. We're just going to go here and darken it. I'm going to do some hue adjustment. Add a bit of green. That's what happens when you don't master it from the very beginning very well. It can be really crappy, the copies that you get after it. And that's a bit too much green. Although the green looks quite nice, come to think of it. It looks like a colour I like called emerald green. So it looks like an almost an emerald kind of green that we've got on this. I don't like it though. I do wonder if we're going to add a background colour. Teal, that's going to blend. It's going to look shit house. Yellow. Yellow, or maybe pumpkin yellow, which is yellow, another form of yellow, but pumpkin. And maybe we could take this hue and maybe drop it down a bit there. Hope this works. Yeah, that looks a bit better. The colour, I'm surprised the background colour came up quite well. I don't know if I like the pumpkin with this. I don't know, folks. But I could do with another colour with this. Trying to think what to do with it, folks. Okay, I do think maybe I'm trying to decide, folks. I'm trying to use my intuition here, folks. Really is can be quite difficult. I'm trying to navigate my way through the possibilities here. I don't always do it right as well as I should. Yeah, that's come up looking a bit better than the pumpkin, I do think. I think it is a bit better than the pumpkin. And I do think maybe we might utilize that as our master copy. I do think I might remove these enlargements and put them back. So 100, I think it was 110 and 140. So I've got to remind myself 110 or 140. Actually, we're going to leave it 110, 140. I've got to remember that. 110, 140. So we're going to print this without the enlargements. And this will become our next master copy. And we'll make something hopefully really nice out of it. So we're trying to redeem our mistake here. So this is it. This is without the enlargement, so that's going to be 140 40 by 110, if I remember correctly. I'm not really good with memory functions, folks, but some things are small enough for me to have stored away in my head for a short time. So this is it. My memory is a problem in real life. I can't learn things. I have problems with mainly my short-term memory, and even worse, the hippocampus, because I had a cord around my neck when I came out of mum. I came out feet first, and basically I had the oxygen starved out of me. So I do suspect I had some brain damage that happened, and yeah, it's just fucked everything up later on in life. It's very difficult learning new things and retaining stuff. I'm trying to get recognised not for my disability but for my ability as a photocopier artist, and that's come up looking again, looks shit house, that pink, that horrible pink. I do like hate it. I do feel like taking out some of that fucking magenta. I do not like it. In this case, magenta has become my enemy, and I know why. I got to get rid of the pink. That's probably made the problem worse. I do think maybe I could move out some of this magenta, maybe just strip it and see what happens. The old saying, folks, see what happens. You know, the old suck it and see attitude. See what happens. See if you get a result. These machines are really strange, behave really strange when you strip colours. And I'm actually quite happy with that overall result. I don't like the green. The green looks a bit too green, but I do like the way it's turned out. Just as I said, the machine does behave a bit strange when you pull colours out altogether. I do think maybe I might have to make this green a little bit more blue rather than the green, or a bit more cyan. So I do think maybe take out some of that greenery. What else was I going to do? I was going to add some of that magenta back, just a fraction, just a small amount to add a bit of character, a bit of flavour. So I fucked up the original mastering. I got a good shape and size, but I got a really bad colour to go with it. And that's come up looking another... See, this is what you call experimental art. And the blue has come up, or should I say mostly a cyan colour, has come up looking really nice. I do think I might take out that magenta altogether because it's made a muddy looking colour. I don't like that muddy look too much. So I think it's the hue that causes that. I think putting in the hue and it's just muddied up the rest of the colouring. So I'm just going to take out the magenta and see what happens again. The old see what happens, sucking and see. But you got to think, use your mind as well. Try to use your mind, but you can't always use your mind. You got to rely on intuition and instinct, and you got to basically, and a bit of trial and error. You know, you got to try a bit of trial and error as well as instinct and all that. So that's come up better. That looks better now. I like that. I quite like it overall. I'm now going to just print off the remaining corners, quadrants. Yeah, folks, I'm missing a lost partner. His name is Luigi. And I'm trying to get these photocopier fiddlings on the 6 o'clock news on the Channel 9. I'm trying to get Channel 9 in particular interested in my work. I believe that they're the best option when it comes to TV network. They've got the most coverage, and I've got a gut feeling that Channel 9 are the most important channel that I can get engaged. Even though sometimes I have been known to swear at them for not putting my stuff up. I do get under the pump feeling, because everything's going up in price and I'm not rich. Being disabled
means I can't afford much. And I'm trying my hardest to afford this, and this is really expensive. And I've taken the drastic measure of not showering any more than roughly once a week, because it's too expensive for the hot water. And I can't afford the electricity. It's all gone up. So I'm trying my best to cut things out that I feel I can do without, and that's one of them. However much, it's not going to be nice in the heat of summer. So I'm hoping this will go to air soon. Don't know when. Anyway, that's come up looking quite a treat. I think we can do another version of this. See how we go. We call a switcheroo. So we're just going to quickly switcheroo these pieces of our North Shore Times made piece. But I'm quite happy with the overall result. The colour is better than I thought, and we've gone on a bit of an adventure trying to get to this stage. And if it wasn't for my bad mastering, it would never have happened. So this is what you could call, in inverted commas, a blessing in disguise. And the old saying, not a religious reference, but yeah, that looks really quite interesting. I think we can now call this demo quits.